Rabina mentioned pushing by the bus. I wanted to share with you something about, it's also appropriate for Rabina to hear. When I used to go back from yeshiva at 6 o'clock before we had asa, or times that the asa wasn't going, so I'd go back with Rafi Ronis Shita. So Rafi and I are good friends aside from colleagues. So the first few times I didn't even notice, but for those of you who get on right by the Yitzhak Le'ir, as Rabina describes, you know, makes a big difference. You know, Matt and I going back to Beit Shemesh, you know, last stop, whether you're going to get a seat or not, is touch and go. Very touch and go. So I would say that I don't push, you know, and I'm not, don't push, but I always noticed that, you know, I would walk towards the bus and Rav Rafi was always 3-4 steps behind me. And then I realized that Rav Rafi Shlita always gets on the last. The last. Rabina talks about that one of the reasons that he quote-unquote fell in love with Rav Nevinsal was that when he would give Rav Nevinsal a ride, he was one of the only people that turned the window back the exact same place that it was. Zvarim Kitanim, Midos, those are things that are very, very important, and they're not easy to do. And Anashim Gedolim are people who are able to do that. And it's a real avoda, which starts off the first Rambam that I wanted to share with you. The Rambam writes in Perek Zayin, Halacha Gimel and Hilchos Tshuva, Al Teimar, She'ein Tshuva Ela Me'avera She'esh Ben Maisa, Kegoin Znus V'gezel Gneva. Don't say that Tshuva is only for sins that entail actions, like incestual relationships, stealing. Ella, k'shem shetzarech adam loshuv me'elu, just like a person has to do tshuva from ma'isim ro'im, kach hu tzarech lechapes b'deyos roz sheyesh lo. He needs to make a cheshbon ha'nefesh for those thoughts. And here the Rambam's usage of deyos is interesting, because the examples that he gives are the losh of min hakas, to do tshuva from anger, umina eva, umina kina, and the Rambam lists all midos rows. Rav Korn Shlita and I often, at this time of year, learn with the Talmidim, in the derech of our great Rabbeim, learn Hilchos Tshuva. We usually don't get the Perek Zayin. I was going through, I borrowed Rav Korn's edition of Ala Tshuva from the Nazir Room, and Rav Soloveitchik's Shiurim as well. In Ala Tshuva, don't really get much far past from Perek Beis. And most of the primary components of Hilchos Tshuva, prior to the philosophical components of Hilchos Tshuva, are really all in the Rambam and Perek Aleph and Perek Beis. The Rambam describes Vidui, the famous Rambam, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu could testify. What is tshuva? That HaKadosh Baruch Hu would testify that we wouldn't sin when we'd be in that position again. Almost all the critical components of the halachas of tshuva are outlined already in Perek Aleph and Perek Beis. What's striking is the Rambam says all the way in Perek Zayin, after the Rambam talks about the Makoros and the Torah of Tshuva, philosophical components of Tshuva, etc., etc., then in Perek Zayin, the Rambam says, and don't think Tshuva is only for Maisim, Tshuva is also on Midos, what the Rosh Yeshiva Shlita was talking about today. If you need to do Tshuva on Midos Rosh, then put it in Perek Aleph, Halacha Aleph, Halacha Beis, Halacha Gimel, where the Rambam describes the averos that need tshuva. Why does the Rambam wait to Perek Zayin? Also, interestingly, the Rambam in Perek Aleph and in Perek Beis describes the vidui that's necessary that goes along with the tshuva. Over here, in Perek Zayin, there's no mention of vidui and midos ros. I want you to think about as you go through Aseret Yemei Teshuva and Yom HaKippurim, whether we really do vidui on midos. Do we do vidui on midos, or is it only on maisios? Sfaradim have class. So that's okay. That's interesting. That's question number two. Yes, Rabbi Daniel. Number three. I want you to think about that. In regards to vidui itself in its classical places in the Rambam in Perek Aleph tells us vidui that you've got to spell out every single avera that you did. That's what the Rambam describes in Perek Aleph. In Perek Beis, the Rambam in Perek Beis Halacha Ches says, "Havidui shenagu bal kol Yisrael." The vidui of Klal Yisrael is the statement, "Avol anachnu chatanu." We sin. The famous question: which vidui is it? Does vidui require pirut achet to specify the sins, or the general statement of "Avol anachnu chatanu"? Another question. Try to cram in a lot in these 15 minutes. The Gemara in Kedushin on Mem Tes on the Bay says that if a person acts in our Masechta, it didn't even dawn on me. We're on Daf Bay's right now to get to Mem Tes, but it's in our Masechta. Rav Kornin Bekiyas Bezer Hashem will get there. Rav Creditor will get there. So the Gemara says if a man is Mekadesh, a woman, a beautiful Gemara, fascinating Gemara. Hareat mekudeshes li amenas she'ani tzadik gomur. What's the halacha? Mekudeshes. Why? Because he could be Maharav Tshuva. If you read the Rambam carefully, the Rambam clearly says that there are two components to Tshuva. In fact, the Rambam emphasizes vidui more than Tshuva itself. In Perek Aleph, the Rav Soloveitchik had some beautiful shiurim on this. Then Perek Aleph, halacha Aleph, the Rambam says that in Ilchos Tshuva, the mitzvah is vidui. Where's the vidui? Amanasha ani tzadik gamor. So there are more questions, but we only have 15 minutes. We'll leave with that. So again, let's review the questions. Number one, why did the Rambam wait Perek Zayin and describe tshuva and midos and Perek Zayin up with all other components of tshuva, Perek Aleph, Perek Beis? Over there, there's no mention of vidui. Yesh la'ayin, whether there's vidui altogether on Midos Ros. The vidui in Perek Aleph is different than the vidui in Perek Beis. What does that tell us? Gemara in Kedushin says that Amnash Ani Tzadik Gamur doesn't need vidui. I was mentioning to Rav Korn this morning that Rav Soloveitchik's Ala Tshuva every single time that one goes through it, it's awesome. And I want to read with you Rav Soloveitchik's explanation for the famous Mishnah. If you don't dance to this Mishnah, there's something wrong with you. Amar Rabbi Akiva, Rabbi Akiva's statement, Ashrechem Yisrael lefnei mi atem mitar eschem. The Rav Zatzal had a tremendous take on what Rabbi Akiva was teaching us. It's brilliant. Listen to, and this is a klisheni from Soloveitchik's original words from the Tshuva Dasha, and this could also be Reb Levi Yitzchak writing, Skusa Yogan Elenu. It could be something the Baal Shem Tov would say. Maimer ze ne'mar kechol hanira. This statement of Rabbi Akiva Ashrechem Yisrael b'samuch achrei achurban. It was Rabbi Akiva's, a little bit after the Churban. V'mieshes nafshenu lamod al melo mashmu'uso aleinu lahavin et hamentaliut that Rabbi Yitzchak said ve'et shivron alev shel ha'yehudim ba'oso shana rishon achar ha'chorban. Think about the mindset of the Jews. You know, it's hard enough when you talk to a guy who's not in the Tiv for Yom Kippur and he's back in America. Think about those first few Yom HaKippurim where there was no more Kayin Gadol. Hine igia Yom HaKippurim upitom ein matzuatzon b'li avedas hayoyim b'li koyin gadol b'li k'toris b'li hayom tov shayosim lo b'tzeisom min HaKodesh Yehudir igishu osa shah kilu akol avud. They felt like everything was lost. Kilu ein lehem takana od kilu lo olamim yisharu shruyim b'choshech v'ozba Rabbi Akiva v'hichriz. Ashrechem Yisrael lefnei miatem mitarim. L'tahara ein atzricha karbonis. Ein atzrichem klein godol. Dai lochem b'mashe katuv b'teira lefnei Hashem k'toru. Ma mikveh mitaris atmei maf HaKadosh Baruch Hu mitaris Yisrael. The Rav's take, the conclusion of Masechas Yuma, is the tragedy of the realization that we don't have at this moment the Kohen Gadol Ba'avodaso, and Rabbi Akiva's mechazek us. Ashreichem Yisrael lefnei, doesn't say lefnei mi atem mechaprim, lefnei mi atem mitaharim. Rav Asher Weiss Shlita suggests, and I believe that this idea is found in Rav Soloveitchik's writings. I wouldn't be surprised if Rav Asher Weiss read Ala Tshuva. Many of his ideas are very similar to the ideas that are found in Ala Tshuva. He takes one of Rav Soloveitchik's ideas to differentiate between, he uses an idea that Rav Soloveitchik says about the difference between Tahara and Kapara, and he adds something that Rav Soloveitchik did not talk about. And that is our first question. Kapara is something that is, as Rashi describes in Bereishis, we don't have enough time to elaborate. Kapara, Rashi explains, is milashon likaneach, to clean, to erase a negative maisa. That's kapara. A maisa needs tshuva with kapara. But there are two parts of Yom HaKippurim. Ki vayom hazeh yichaper aleichem, kapara, and then it concludes with lefnei Hashem titaru. Rav Asher suggests that Perek Zayin of Hilchos Tshuva, the Rambam is describing a different component of Tshuva. It's not the component of kapara, which is in Perek Aleph and Perek Beis, but it's the component of tahara. And for midos rows that permeate a person's nefesh, there the cleansing is not one of kapara, there the cleansing is tahara. Kapara of Perek Aleph and Perek Beis of Hilchos Tshuva, that has vidui. If we have time, we're going to still try to be masbir. What is the difference between the kapara of Perek Aleph and the kapara of Perek Beis? Tahara doesn't come along with vidui. Tahara is something that is spontaneous, that doesn't relate to a particular action, but it's ma'mikve mitaris hatmeim af HaKadosh Baruch Hu mitaris Yisrael. And what Rabbi Akiva is mechazek us on is at the end of the day, even though we no longer have a shliach of the Kohen Gadol, but at the same time, ultimately the Kohen Gadol would cry out at the moment in which he said the vidui, titaru. He would call out to Bnei Yisrael in the Migdash, be mitar yourself, because ain shliach l'tahara. There is no shliach when it comes to tahara. If you read the Rambam in Perek Aleph Halacha Beis in regards to the Sa'ir Yom HaKippurim, so there the Sa'ir Yom HaKippurim comes from all of Klal Yisrael, and there the Kohen Gadol is a shliach. But that's the bechina of kapara of the Sa'ir la'azazel, which is mechaper on some mitzvos. Not all. Rambam says only the kalos. But midos, that's something that ultimately requires the process of tahara. Tahara is not connected to the tzibur. Tahara is something that's very pure and unique to the individual. There's no reference of tahara in regards to all of Klal Yisrael. Tahara is something that's very personal. That's what the Kohen Gadol would call out, even Bezman HaMikdash, Ki Taharu. That's the Bechina of Lefnei Hashem Titaru. That's the Pshat in Kedushin Mem Tes HaMebeis. The Gemara in Kedushin says, Al Menashe Ani Tzadik Gomur. So you could have a person that does tshuva in the Bechina of Kapara, but then you could have someone else who does tshuva bebechinas tahara. That bechina of tshuva al yidei tahara, that moment of hirur tshuva, That could be achieved without vidui. Now there are strengths and there are weaknesses in both the bechina of tahara as well as the bechina of kapara. In terms of kapara, if a person is connected to the tzibur, is connected to the soyer mishtaleach, so then, by simply being connected to Klal Yisrael, then it's automatically a kapara of averus kalos, but not all averus. And that's reflected in the bracha Yom HaKippurim itself. Melech moichal avoynoseinu va'avoynos kol amoy beis Yisrael. There's tzvei dinim in the Birchas Hayom of Yom HaKippurim. One is on avonoseinu, our personal averos, and then there's va'avonos kol amoy beis Yisrael. There's averus of all of Klal Yisrael. In Kenim Advarim, we could go back to Perek Aleph and Perek Beis. We asked, and in Perek Aleph, the Yochid in the Bechina of Kapara, there he has to spell out every single Avera. And in Perek Beis, the Rambam says that the tshuva over there is Avol Anachnu Chatanu. It seems that there are three different traps. Perek Aleph, Perek Beis, and Perek Zayin and Ilchos Tshuva, and different components of Tshuva of Yom HaKippurim. Perek Beis is the kapara of the klal. There, it's Avol Anachnu Chatanu. There, the Kohen Gadol is a shliach as representative of all of Klal Yisrael. Perek Aleph is the Tshuva of the Yachid. But both of those tshuvas are the tshuvas of kapara. Perek Aleph is kapara of the Yachid. Perek Beis is kapara of the Tzibur. Perek Zayin, that's tahara. Coming back to yeshiva, here's the pitch for just yeshiva itself. You won't tell me to say anything about yeshiva, but just coming back to yeshiva and being part of a makom Torah that's miyuchad. And every person here, I know, I'm zochet to know many of the people that are sitting here. I look around and I know that so many people have different experiences and different sharm with different rabbeim, but every single person here had a unique experience to be mechaber to the tzibur, something that is nadir. Because as Rav Soloveitchik described, Rabbi Akiva's menachem us, he says, yes, you personally, the ball's in your court. Tahara is in your court. But in some ways, Perek Beis of Hilchos Tshuva today is even harder than once upon a time was. For someone to really, really feel connected to Jews that are so different than them coming tonight, that's the Rambam's describing in Perek Beis. And that Bechina of the Kohen Gadol, the Ichud Ha'am, Va'avonos Kol Amo Beis Yisrael, that's an Avoda. And that's why there's a responsibility for an alumnus to come back to yeshiva. That's why there's a responsibility for someone to be involved in a shul, for someone to be connected to a Tzibur of Torah. That's the Rambam in Perek Beis. And then there's another responsibility. And that's a responsibility for an individual to be honest, to make a cheshbon ha-nefesh of every single one of those maisim. That's the Rambam and Perek Aleph. That's the other bechina of kapara. Rambam and Perek Aleph. And then there's a third thing, which is the purest. Not connected to a tzibur. It's not connected to a maisa. It's taharas ha-pnimis. And that, Rabbi Akiva says, is not dependent on time and place. Ashreichem Yisrael. Kadosh Baruch Hu should give us siyata d'shmaya. There's so much more to say. Eiz Hashem, we should be zocha to discuss it in the Beis Hamikdash, the Binyana, watching the Kohen Gadol b'Avodasai. It was an amazing confluence that we were zocha once upon a time too. And now there's a challenge. Perek Aleph, Perek Beis, and Perek Zayin are not as easy to achieve simultaneously. It's a responsibility that we have. It's the avoda, and that's certainly true. We should be zocha to plumb the depths of kapara, kapara sayochid, kapara satzibur, and taras atnimius, and be zocha, Bezer Hashem, to see the kohen gadol ba'avodasu b'chol mashmo'usa.